to Lohre Farm, everybody. Today I'm with Libby and we're going to teach you how to make fermented plant juice. We're going to use these dandelions here to make it. Now last year I made quite a bit of this stuff using our tomato plants. We had such an overabundance of tomato plants that it only made sense to make it out of that. And what I did was I used that tomato plant and turned it into this fermented plant juice, mixed it in with my water solutions anytime I went out to the garden to water, and fed those nutrients directly back into all the other garden plants and vegetables. Over the winter, I also used it to feed our plants that we keep inside the house. And in my personal opinion, it did make a huge bit of difference. The plants looked a lot healthier over the winter. You know, being that we're in Minnesota, we have a lot less sun in the winter time here. And it really seemed to make a huge difference all winter long, keeping the plants looking and seemingly being much more healthy. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to gather a few materials. Some of the things that you're going to want to gather are going to be brown sugar. You're going to want to get a mixing container. You're also going to want to get fermenting containers. You're going to want to have a scale. You can gather some rubber bands. Otherwise, the way that I do it, you don't need to gather rubber bands. I use the lids off of the jars as my rubber bands. And you're also going to want to pick out your plant material. Like I said, in this case, we're going to use dandelions. I've read a lot of good things about that online, and I really am eager to try this one out. Like I said, I had very good success, in my personal opinion, with the tomato plants, as far as them providing lots of extra nutrients to the other plants that we had in the greenhouse last year. So we'll get started. The first thing that we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna weigh how much plant material we have and see exactly what that weight is. And then we're gonna add that much equal weight in brown sugar to the plant weight. So we've weighed out our plant material and we have pretty much exactly 1 pound of dandelions here. So then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take 1 pound of brown sugar and I'm gonna add that in with the dandelion. All right, now that we have our brown sugar weighed out, equal weight to our dandelion root, now what we wanna do is we wanna start to mix this together, basically making sure that the dandelion has every part of it covered in brown sugar. We want as much brown sugar covering everything as we possibly can. I've noticed sometimes while I'm working the brown sugar around the plant leaves, it'll start to liquefy in my hands. That's okay, that's kind of what we want. We want to have it be completely covered in that brown sugar material. Well, we got our plant material all mixed up with the brown sugar now. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna transfer that material from this mixing container into some fermentation jars where it's gonna spend the next 5 to 10 days fermenting and turning into our FPJ, fermented plant juice. The other thing I was gonna mention too is whatever plant material you choose, you want to make sure that it's not a poisonous plant. And you also want to make sure that you go out and you pick it really early in the morning, preferably before the sun comes up, you know, kind of like that time when the grass is still really dewy. That'll be the best time to make your collection. During the course of the night, the plants have been basically pushing all of their nutrients out into the furthest growing leaves that they have. So those would be the areas that you would want to cut, those leaf areas on the ends. The final step we want to do before we put covers on these jars is we want to give them basically like a brown sugar cap, just right on top of the plant material. Just do like a little, maybe 1/4 inch or 1/8 inch cap of brown sugar. That'll just help out in the fermenting process and the way that the plant kind of starts to break down. Now that we have our plant material ready, one last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to just give the jar a wipe down with a rag covered in vinegar, just to make sure that we don't attract any unwanted ants or any other bugs that would come around. Now you're gonna wanna cover this with probably like a paper towel. Some people like to use a rubber band on top. I've found that if I use the actual original lids that the jar came with, just use the ring, that kind of works as its own rubber band. So you're just gonna wanna take the paper towel, put it on top, and I just press down a little bit and screw the top on. You're gonna wanna let these sit about 5, maybe 7, possibly 10 days if you're dealing with a little bit cooler environment. Keep them out of direct sunlight, keep them in a shaded area. I'll probably store them down in our basement and we'll check back in on them in about, I don't know, 5 to 7 days and see where they're at. Well, welcome back to Lohre Farm, everybody. It's been 6 days since Libby and I started our fermented plant juice using dandelions, and the results are going pretty good. Things are really fermenting along nicely, and I think today we're gonna do the extraction. What I usually like to do for the extraction is I got myself a little funnel with a screen that seems to work pretty good, and then I usually just go find myself a jar to extract into, and that'll be a nice jar that anytime I want to use this, I can just take that and I can take that out and mix that with water. What's the dilution rate for fermented plant juice? Do you remember?
1 to 1,000.
1 to 1,000, that's right. Yep, so this is going to get diluted out pretty far. So a little bit of this stuff is going to go a long ways in the garden. What I usually do is I set this funnel up on top of a jar, and basically just take my other, take the jar of fermented plant juice, tip it upside down on top. This is gonna take a while to extract. This is a pretty slow process. Usually what I'll do is just kind of set this up somewhere safe, walk away, come back a little bit later, see how things are going. Well, we're all done with extraction. So we're gonna set this up for storage. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to store this in a breathable container. So I usually just go back to the paper towel, put the paper towel on top as a breathable container. Well, thank you for watching How to Make Fermented Plant Juice. I'll include some links in the description on where you can find more information about fermented plant juice, as well as other Korean natural farming amendments.